Hi guys, welcome to my YouTube channel. My name is Jesudunmo. If this is your first time of visiting my channel, this channel is about life, love, law, and light. And today we'll be talking about how to handle miscarriages, barrenness basically. And with me today are my amazing parents. They've been together for 33 years and they've had quite the number of miscarriages. So they have put a strong goal of experience with barrenness and miscarriage. So this is my mom, Pastor Abimbola Loge, and yes, this is my dad, Pastor Adibola Loge. And the first question I'll be asking them is, we'll be doing our usual five tips. Can you give us five tips on how you went through it all?
Thank you very much.
Please come on.
Our marriage was built on principle. I met my wife on the 16th of June, the year 1987, at the University of Ibadan. Since that fateful day, we have been having a very strong friendship. And when we married, that friendship was growing stronger and stronger.
So this first point is friendship.
Yes, and during dependency of our problem of miscarriages, the friendship was too strong, too muscular, and too overwhelming to be dislocated or perverted by problem of miscarriages.
So no matter the strain, it was important that your friendship was good. So for what about people that are not friends, what do you think they should do?
Those who are not friends, they have to consciously create atmosphere of friendship.
So they have to be intentional about it.
They must be intentional about it. They must desire it. They must go for it, and they will have it.
Okay, thank you very much. Mommy, do you have a point for us?
Two things to do is that you should run on same principles.
Wow.
Because if your goals and your ideas are different, to handle miscarriages will be difficult.
Or barrenness at all.
Or barrenness at all. So one of them, apart from friendship, is we were able to build on the solid rock Jesus. As born-again Christians, we had the same goal to obey the scriptures, to fear God, and to believe in the ability of God to make impossibility possible.
Okay.
So I want to advise you, run on the same principles. So vis-a-vis, we had this opinion, this is my husband, this is my wife for life. Mm. Babies or no babies.
Oh, good.
We are first friends. And like I also know, that whether you like it or not, you better be friends as early as possible in your marriage. If you're ever going to have it to work the way you want to be happy, you want to be fulfilled in it. So, to the glory of God, we started out being friends. Then later,
same set of principles
okay. Was our guiding line.
Okay. So, do you have, what's the point three? We have point one, friendship,
then,
point two, no, same
three,
set of principles.
I think number three basically is love.
Oh.
We love each other. My husband treats me like a baby. And that started out from day one. And I honor him and I celebrate him like a big brother. In fact, that was how we started from. So there's this love aspect of it that helped us to, every time there was a miscarriage or there was going to be a miscarriage, he stood with me. He kept on telling me.
We went through it together?
We went through it together and he kept on telling me, don't worry. They went so far to keep me standing.
Oh, wow.
I saw times when I even wanted to give up and I was almost collapsing on the principles that I held on to. He kept on telling me God does not fail.
Okay. So when one person is
off, loving each other.
The other person, when one person feels down, the other person is always there to support.
Yes.
Okay. So Daddy, what do you have to say about love that she just talked about?
Because of love that was existing strongly between my wife and I, we didn't allow the scourge of miscarriages to make us downcast or to start having extraneous thought or look. The love was too strong, was too captivating and overwhelming. So the love really gave us a lot of unity, oneness. So we fought the battle together because the love was indivisible.
I remember you talking about you coming home from work to just check on her.
During that problem, I was the Oyo State Police PRO. I was always coming home from the office, taking about 30 minutes from the office to see my wife and to tell her that I love you.
Even when I
and don't allow anything to make you frustrated that we will definitely have our children.
Okay, so love was the reason why, like she just said, even when she wants food outside, you buy the food, you accommodated little changes that happened over the period, mood swings, everything that was going on.
Yeah,
you handled it. And you handled it, or it was the one that was calm most of the time.
And you know, because in miscarriages, most people want to blame the woman. The whole thing rests on you. So you need a man that is quite understanding, a man that is loving, a man that is supportive, a man that is encouraging.
Go the extra mile.
The fact you couldn't go anymore because now it's like carrying a load, a bowl of water or a bucket of water in your head, and you suddenly fall and you spill it, and then thank God the bucket is not broken. The water is over, is just gone. And you don't know how you're going to fix it. And here comes somebody, don't worry, I'm behind you. We can go back and fetch it again. That to me is all you need at this time. You know, another thing is hope.
Point four.
Yes, that's point four. Hope, to me, is the reason why we are together today and will be forever together. Just keep on hoping that one day is one day, this problem will be over. No, and you don't look at other people's situations to begin to compare. Because that can be really between. A lot of people who got married shortly before us and after us, they started having babies immediately. Sometimes I would look at them and I would almost be frustrated. But my husband, he kept on telling me, just hope. And at some point, I had to tell myself, my name is Abimbola Nunge. I'm not Mrs. somebody else. So this is my marriage. It must work. And because God is the balancer and the adjuster of the relationship or this marriage, my hope in him will not fail. Today, our testimony is different. Hope, I say to you, hope again.
Okay, Daddy.
Let me add to that. Because of our belief in God, we had strong faith that because God has promised that none shall be barren in the land, we are hope that we will not have a problem of not having children, no matter the problem of miscarriages.
Awesome. You mentioned one time that it was immaterial for you whether or not you had children. Did that influence your attitude in that period, that your marriage was a priority? Did that make, before you had the final point, I just want to ask that question.
Okay, let me just quickly say this. It was really immaterial because marriage is not really it's not for babies. That you must really understand. Marriage is really for companionship. Even though in the African context and opinion, any married that refuses to produce babies, they see you as failures, they give you my names, labels and rest. But in the real sense of it, marriage, the good reason for marriage is for companionship and fellowship. If the relationship in the marriage is growing, I tell you, you live in an atmosphere of joy, you are relaxed. Most often than not, God lives in such atmosphere. And so prayers are easily answered and problems are easily handled, are well handled when you love each other and you are relaxed and you know that the reason for this marriage is not about producing babies. And one of the few things I used to tell myself, whether I like it or not, these children will go. Now we are growing older, you know. And I discovered that some of them now, hello, where are you? Mommy, I'm busy. I'll call you back later. So we're already having a feel of what it will look like. It's not that they're very responsible children to the glory of God, but they can't be there. So you build your marriage knowing that even if you have 10, 20, if I have 1 million children, a day will be a day. Yourself and your husband will still be the only party in that relationship. So build your hope, build your marriage for relationship and for fellowship.
Okay, thank you very much. So one thing I'm also getting from this is that you need to remember that you cannot fill your marriage up with children. You are the priority in the marriage.
Yeah.
Okay, so point five, final point.
Before I talk about point five, I want to say when I married,
close up please, Daddy.
As I have said, our marriage was built on friendship. I wanted children, but I wouldn't want my love for children to affect my love for my friend, who is my wife, Abimbola. Because of that, I was ready to forgo everything and reinforce our friendship. And that I did without any hesitation. Point five, we talk about the medical and the spiritual aspect. We did all the medical tests that we could do. They told my wife that we were not having any problem. And immediately we knew we were not having any problem medically. We now turned to the spiritual aspect of it. and God answered our prayer. Glory.
Understanding what exactly you're going through medically is important. That's point five. Covering all the bases, including medical.
It's very important. Don't take anything for granted. Good. Don't just assume. Know what you're fighting. It's very important that you go for medical tests. Know if it is hormonal. Know if it is infection you have to treat. Know if it is one thing or the other. Don't just be beating. Don't be fighting like somebody that is beating the hair.
Okay.
So if you know exactly where the problem is, as you attend to it medically, you can also spiritually attack it. Because to every physical appearance of any problem, there is spiritual backup. Yes.
Some people will not agree with that, but then that's
okay. So for us, we went through all the medical aspect of, like my husband said earlier, we went for the first one, the second one, we went to professionals, I went to a gynecologist.
So you had different
we had
opinions.
Different opinions. And when my mom came up that we should come to Lagos, my husband said, no, this is my wife, she's going to stay with me. And so we went to another one, after they did it, and the doctor told me, you have no medical problem. As I asked, I made some inquiries. Is there anything wrong with my husband? They said, no, these are the results.
Oh, so that means, perfect. Sorry to interrupt you, mom. But it just occurred to me, both of you, because I noticed some people, it's just one party that usually goes
to medical
test.
The two of us went there together.
All the tests you went to.
Yes, that's why we are saying you must be together.
You must be friends.
Yeah, you must be friends. To fight miscarriages, you must be together. You know, and the beautiful thing there, the woman needs to be patient. That's why we need the man to be really supportive. And so we had to go through all the medical whatever. When it comes to barrenness, go through it together and smile all the way through. In fact, immediately we leave the place, we are already jumping, hopping, and then touching each other, laughing about it.
Good.
So to the glory of God, we have
opportunity to try again.
Ah, Jesus is Lord.
Amen. And final question, because I know this is, because this for people who are in settings where, okay, like Africa, people always have something to say about, why is your tummy still flat? What's going on? How did you handle that? How did you deal with external intrusion?
Some people came to us from my father's house, and they came to us from my mother's house. We checkmated them. We didn't allow them to use their extraneous belief and interest to cause disunity in our marriage, or to cause marital disequilibrium. Because of that, we continue fighting our battle together, and God gave us victory. Okay. Today, we have a lot of testimonies.
Yep.
For every shame we had, we have double testimonies.
Yes.
Now. Glory be to God.
Hallelujah.
I still want to say that I love my wife,
aww,
and she is my friend. And those who are facing that problem, they should confront the problem from angle of friendship, angle of love, angle of prayer, and then they can approach it medically as well. May I believe that we can do all things through Christ that strengthens us.
Okay.
Praise the Lord.
So this is a good place to round up. If you've been watching this video thus far, this is a good time to leave a comment, like this video. Mommy, your final words?
Hey, let me just say this. I can't imagine if we did not wait on the Lord, or if we did not keep loving each other and keep trying. Because now the results we are getting from this marriage is way beyond the problems of miscarriages we initially faced.
Okay.
So wait, stay in there. It's going to work.
They were faithful to each other.
And the beautiful thing, if I walked away from the relationship, I will leave you with this. Winners do not quit, and quitters, they do not win. So to win in that relationship, in that marriage, make sure to win even the battle over miscarriages. Stay there.
Okay.
And God that gave me victory, we give you victory.
Okay.
God bless you.
Thank you very, very much for watching. Don't forget to like, subscribe, leave a comment. You could also leave a comment about what topics you'd like to see them discuss next time they are on here. Thank you very much. I love you guys. Bye.
We love you too.
Daddy, smile.
Mm, love you.